In the last few months, Figma's AI capabilities have been significantly improving every day. So many new releases. Today, I'm going to show you 10 fantastic AI features hidden inside Figma Design that will make your workflow so much faster and so much more efficient. I am going to use a simple application right here, a simple mobile application, and we're going to explore all these different features. I want you to note, because many of you, my viewers, are in international countries, like different places, please note that my interface may look different because I live in Canada, which is North America, so we get some of the most recent releases. Most importantly, the account from which I'm demoing is an enterprise paid account. I want to show you with my current interface where all these AI features live. Right here under the Actions menu. And the shortcut for that is also Command K. Right now, I have nothing selected, so I can see all the different tools that are available to me through AI. However, please note that this menu actually changes based on what you select. So if I had it closed here, if I were to select this card, and if I open it, some of the suggestions become different based on what I have selected. The AI in Figma is kind of guessing what I could do with the selected part. So let's start with one of the first features that I really like here, which is Make Image. You can see here, this feature is using by default the latest Gemini 2.5 Nano Banana, but you can also change it to different aspects. I'm going to keep it to the default, and I will give a simple prompt saying, add an image of a young boy eating a carrot. And I will click Make It, and here you go. There's this beautiful image of a child eating a carrot, and this is a post that I wanted. Once you've created an image, you always have the ability to make changes to the image. So there's different places where you can access this, either from the menu itself, and you can see for some reason it's hidden, the edit image. But in the search bar, I'm going to type edit, and you will see edit image becomes available to me. I can click on it to edit the image, but also, in case it's hidden, another place to do that is if you double click on the image and you see it here in your additional layers panel, you can see edit image is available to you. And both of these things will allow you to edit the image. So if I were to click on this, once again, Nano Banana is there. So with my image selected, I'm going to say, for example, remove the watering can from the background. And I'll click edit image, and you will see it is pretty accurate. It should be able to spot on, remove that can without distorting the rest of the image. Perfect. This is exactly what I wanted. The next tasks I'm going to show you are related to content, and they are super useful. I want to select all these tasks coming here. And the first tool that is super handy is Translate Content. So clicking that, I will say translate this content to Arabic. I'm going to use Arabic just to show you how drastic the visual would look. And it's doing its magic. Here you go. My app was translated to Arabic in just one click in Figma Design. I know we've used plugins before, we've used different things, we've had to duplicate our screens, which was okay, but this is fantastic to have it inbuilt inside Figma without me having to leave the file. So I'm going to undo this, stick with English, and show you some of the other content tools that are available to us through Figma AI. Replace content. For your reference, replace content can select one layer or multiple layers of content, and it can transform it with context that you give it to it. Suppose you're not sure about what a specific AI tool can do. If you come right here, do you see where it says AI? If you click on the Learn More, it opens your browser and it shows you the Figma documentation for that. So it's very, very useful. I'm going to use replace content and say, replace the vegetables with a mix of fruits and vegetables or flowers. Keep the tasks 2 lines. And I'm clicking replace content. Now it's thinking, and here you go. It created a mixture. So the next very useful content AI tool that we can utilize is Rewrite This. So I'm going to click this and you can see the suggestions were able to guess that this is content. So they surfaced Rewrite This to me. It's giving you a hint here in a softer, more patient tone. Instead, I want to say in a more professional, convincing tone. By the way, if you notice, I've clicked enter multiple times because my expectation as a user is that when I click enter, it would move ahead, but it's not doing that. And this is simply to give me the ability to format. Because remember, when we're writing prompts, sometimes if your prompt is more complex, you might want to add points. And I think that's why Figma did not leverage the enter button to do this. So you have to come here and click either command enter, you see that's the shortcut, or rewrite. So I'm clicking command enter now. Awesome, it's rewriting my content. This is way more professional. And to wrap up content, there is under riffing and writing, the shorten extension, where if you click it, it shortens the text once again. Next, one of my favorite AI tools that I want to show you is Rename Layers. In the past, we often use plugins or different things or manually try to rename our layers. It's so much more helpful to have certain layers renamed. So when I click on the actions and click Rename Layers, you'll see first I get notified it's renaming 0 out of 28 layers. And if I look right here, all these frame 1, frame 2 start changing to become named correctly in a way that adds significance and context to my app. Continuing with images, there's two more capabilities that I want to show you. Have you ever needed an image and just went straight to Google to actually get a sample image that you can use as a placeholder? So I'm gonna say pictures of blueberries and strawberries. You can either drag it and drop it in your Finder, or another way of doing that is right-clicking and saying copy image. And you can go directly to Figma and click Command V or paste. Do you see, as I pasted this image, I can already see that the resolution is not doing well. So using the Figma AI, I will come here and click on Boost Resolution. And you will see the results have been stunning. I've been very, very happy to see what it's able to do. You have two layers with boost resolution. It keeps the older one right here in case you don't like it. It hides it underneath and the new boosted resolution image goes on top. So moving on to the last image feature that's super useful. In the past, I have used a plugin to remove the background, but with the Figma native functionality, this happens so much better. And I find that it works better when you do it from the specific action, remove background, rather than do it in Nano Banana itself. If you're more interested to learn the intricacies of that, I have a big video about this. And you can see the background was very efficiently removed. I'm going to undo that because I don't love this change. And now that I've finished adding all the images and text that I want to show you one of my favorite Figma AI new features, which is adding interactions to enable you to prototype your design much faster. This tab bar here is the main component that I need to repeat everywhere on the different screens of my app, and I want it to link to those different screens. So I'm going to click Option and drag to get an instance of it, and I will cut that, and I'm going to paste it everywhere on my frame. I'm going to select all four of these screens. I will click on my action toolbar once again, and I will say add interactions. And you can see from nothing, it suddenly created all these interactions to the different pages within my app. Let's see how accurate that is. So let's open the prototype to test this. If I click on tasks, it already recognized my tasks page. And mind you, this is happening correctly because renaming my layers has helped the AI recognize these different pages. So for example, if I come to the community page, it recognizes that I need to log in before being able to come here. Now, there's one more thing that I would like to do, which is add vertical scrolling and make my tab bar stick in place. Do we think we can do this with this add interaction feature? Let's try. First of all, let me go to my prototype settings and actually set a device. When you're setting a prototype, you want to make sure that the width of your frame is actually the same width of the prototypes. The width of my frames is actually 390. So I want to come to prototype, and when selecting what is the device that I want to have, instead of resizing everything on my screen, ideally I want to choose an iPhone that has a 390. And here you go, that's an iPhone 14. So selecting that. Now when I come here to the actual prototype, you can see things are fitting perfectly. You can further refine this here in the prototype settings, because right now it's scrolling with parents. So what you have to do is say fixed, stay in place. But I want to see if I could do this with the add interaction. So if I come here and click on add interaction, nothing has actually happened. Message that we get is select a few top frames in order to do this. So I think this is not yet in place. I can see how Figma is trying to do this, but currently with this iteration, I have to do it manually and say fix, stay in place. What I'd have to do is select the whole frame, click command and shorten that, bring it all the way here under my nav bar. So to ensure that the scrolling still happens after I resized my frame, I would have to come here and you see the scroll behavior. It's set to no scrolling, but I want it to be vertical. And now if I come back here, you'll see I'm able to vertically scroll and my tab bar is still where it is. If you want to learn fully extensive and advanced prototyping, I have a video that I'm linking to you up here that will teach you the very basics of variants and variables. As you can see, there is so much happening with Figma. There's new releases every day. There's actually one release that I'm currently testing in alpha, which is going to be the highlight of what we can do as designers with Figma. Being able to prompt our design, Figma has announced that feature, prompt to edit, but it's still in alpha and I'm testing it, so we're not able to share it with you yet. If you're really interested in keeping track of all these releases as they come out, I have made it my mission to share them with you. So I normally hate to say this. I don't want to be one of those YouTubers who's telling you to subscribe and like. I trust that you will do whatever is conducive for you, but I'm going to show you this because it is hidden in YouTube. So if you want to stay aware of what's happening, it's not enough that you subscribe to see all the videos that are coming from creators that you care for. It's very important that you click on that notification bell and select all. The default YouTube selection for notification is personalized, so this will not let you know of everything that comes out. And if you want to keep track of the latest, I highly recommend that you click on all. This will give you a notification when something new comes up, like prompt to edit. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope this is helpful for you. If you have any questions or comments or things you want to learn about, leave them for me in the comment. I make sure to read every comment and respond.